So I'm assuming the Family Matters disc, like this disc, is probably the one going back to which one was it? Euphoria? Is this the one back to Euphoria? Because I know that Kendrick dropped more diss tracks than Drake, but I'm not too sure which one's the right one.
Maybe in this song, you shouldn't start by saying,
"Nigga, I said it, I know that you
I
ain't."
can't believe he made a music video about Kendrick.
Maybe in this song, you shouldn't start by saying,
"Nigga, I said it, I know that you mad."
Okay. I get it. I get it. So he's basically talking about the flip on Euphoria about how you can't say the N-word.
And I've emptied the clip over friend of your.
Wait, I've emptied the clip over friendlier jabs. Friendlier jabs, as in the first one, as in the push-ups, 50 push-ups. So I empty the clip, as in empty the clip in terms of shooting.
Jazz, you mentioned my seed, now deal with his dad.
Mention my seed because Kendrick mentioned his seed about how it's not like having a dad, you know, but you know.
And I gotta go bad, I gotta go bad.
Is this like. This car scene in this video, right? Is it very similar to that one Kendrick song, Mad City? Maybe. I'm sure it is, right? Okay, this is Toronto. Toronto.
Really trying to keep it PG. I was really trying to keep it PG. If you had to set a
Care rental guidance, yeah.
video as a DP,
TP.
civilian gang in real like you PC.
Two civilian getting real like you PC.
You know who really bang set my nigga YG.
YG.
You know who really bang set my nigga Chuck T. You know who even bang set out there CB.
You know who even bang out a set out there? A set like a bar, but also a bar as in like a set, but also a set like CB. CB is Chris Brown. Chuck T. PC. Two civilians getting real like UPC.
Yeah, like you PC.
It's
You
a
know who really
double.
bang set my nigga YG. You know who really bang set my nigga Chuck T. You know who even bang set out there CB. And nigga Cole losing sleep on this, it ain't.
Okay, talking about Cole apologizing.
You better have some paperwork that that shit fake T.
You better have something that's real, or else it's just a lie based on fake tea. Fake tea. Fake tea. Like, I get it. I understand what he's saying, but isn't there a better way to word this?
Can't be rapping by no writing that we can't read.
Okay, can't be saying things that are lies. I mean, it's true. Someone slimed me for my AP. So someone took your watch.
I mean, it's true, a nigga slimy for my AP. Just like how Metro nigga slimy for his main squeeze.
Dissing Metro
I've been
again?
begging for attention, nigga, say please. Always rapping like you about to
Okay,
blow.
he's talking about how he wants to grow big, like Kendrick wants to get big, so therefore you need to diss Drake in order to do that, big boying him. Always rapping like you about to get the slaves freed. Talking about Black
The
history.
slave's free. You just acting like an activist. It's make believe.
Just saying that Kendrick is fake based on what his moral compass is, but I'm sure his name, like they call him, like, is it Dr. Morrell or Dr. Moral or
Don't even go back to your hood and plant no money trees.
Money Trees, because Kendrick has a song Money Trees.
Say you hate the girls I fuck, but what you really mean?
Wait.
Go back to your hood and plant no money trees. Say you hate.
You say you hate the girls I fuck, but what you really mean?
The girls I fuck, but what you really mean? I've been with black and white and everything that's in between.
Was Kendrick meeting one of the girls? I guess so. The two bad bitches. Yeah, that line. Maybe that line. You, the black messiah, wifing up a mixed queen. Talking about Whitney again,
You the black messiah,
because
wifey,
Whitney's mixed,
up
right?
a mixed queen and hit vanilla cream to help out with
And hit Vanilla Cream to help out with your self-esteem.
your
I
sister.
don't really understand this line. Maybe like Vanilla Cream, as in like white privilege.
Sting. Also, Bobby, shit, I wanna know.
On some Bobby shit, I want to know what Whitney need. Bobby and Whitney, like Whitney
Know
Houston.
what Whitney need. All that puppy love was over in y'all late teens.
All that puppy love was over in your late teens. He's talking about how it was over, because I know that Kendrick dated his girl since like his early age, because they've been their first loves, right? I might be wrong here, guys. I didn't read the Wikipedia about this, but I'm just assuming that like when he's talking about Whitney in the late teens, he's talking about that puppy love, that you know, that normal love is over. It's gone.
Why you never hold your son and tell him say cheese? We could have left the kids out of this, don't blame me.
Damn. Play Sweet Puppy Love. Your baby mama captions always screaming, save me. I'm not too sure. Wait, you did her dirty all her life and you're trying to make peace? Is he talking about his mother? Oh, baby mama. Never mind. I got it, guys. Baby mama as in like, his wife, as in Whitney again. Are you sure, Drake? Are you sure that Kendrick did dirty to, Whitney? Day Free? Like, Day Free is, like, I know that Kendrick has somebody, like, is it a producer or somebody? Like, his manager or something? Like, his best friend named Day Free? Wait, I heard that one of them little kids might be Day Free? Okay, I get the video now. So he's grabbing the truck and he's putting it inside the trash. Again, that's reference to Mad City. Because Mad City, if you've seen the album, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe, is it called Mad City? But that's all I remember. So, like, in terms of the truck, right? Or in terms of the car, right? He's crushing the car, crushing the album, crushing the cover, but also mocking Kendrick. Okay, wait, what? GM, is that general manager? Business manager? Maybe I'm wrong about this. I don't know. This is all making plenty of fucking sense to me. Hey, let that shorty breathe. Shake that ass, bitch. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Shake that ass for Drake. Now shake that ass for free. Yeah. Is he talking about, like shaking booty in the club? Maybe, I don't know, guys. Well, not that kind of free. I'm talking about the N-word, Dave. But also, like, Dave as in Dave Free. A mini Dre. Wait. Your man, a little K, we call that shit a mini Drake. A mini Drake, like he acts like Drake, but also your man, a little K, as in like a little Uzi. Because again, if you put the words together just based on the lyrics, right? AK, maybe I'm wrong, maybe Richard. He always said, I overlooked him. I was staring straight. So I was. Like, I knew exactly what Day Free did. He always said I overlooked him, saying that I was better than him, but I always knew that this is what you were doing. But also staring straight, because it sounded to me like he said Dre, but Kendrick said, I know you like to keep it short, so let me paraphrase. Knew it was smoke when Abel hit us with the serenade. Niggas say, almost started reaching for my waist. Okay, dropping like his waist, grabbing his gun, but also Abel hitting with the serenade when you sang, but he also sang it out. Okay, crushing the car, crushing his album cover. Okay. Beat switcher. Yeah.
Just stop playing around and take this shit seriously.
What?
Niggas is a joke, I take it seriously.
Okay.
Yeah.
What is this?
Look, if Drake shooters doing TikToks, nigga really shooting you.
Wait. It's just switching up now. Wait.
Look,
if Drake shooters doing TikToks, nigga really shooter in your gang, that's P's bros. P's brother, y'all ain't getting shit shot. Here, wait, falsetto reference his music, but also falsetto and music. Wait. Can't listen to stick talk in falsetto, save it for a hip hop. So basically saying that Kendrick is not about hip hop, but he can't listen to the stick. The stick is like the stick talk, as in like, you're not about this life, bro. So just keep it and save it for hip-hop, but also hip-hop and falsettos. Falsetto is what you use in music, in terms of tones. You don't even be at home, dog. You a souvenir out the gift shop. Gift shop souvenir. You're not at home. You're not a dad. Don't need to be at home, dog. You a souvenir out the gift shop, nigga. Still mad about that one hoe. We ain't even fuck. I just live locked with her. I get acting when it's war time. I ain't even really let my dick drop, nigga. What the fuck? I heard Rick drop. Rick drop like Rick Ross. Nigga talking something about a nose job. Some type of no job? Did Rick Ross talk about some type of no job? Nose job, I mean? I'm nigga owes him. We got a side effect of jealousy and doubt. I never told y'all, nigga. Just put a nigga in the bars. Let a nigga rock. Kind of like your old job. Wait, what? Wait. In the bars, let rot, kind of like your old job. Because you rot in the bars? Or you rot in the bars? It's a double, I know, but... House sitting on some land, but it's out where no even... What? No even really know y'all? Sitting on some land, but it's out where no one even really knows y'all. Cause he stays in the house all the time because he talked about his family, cause Kendrick talked about how he stays home all the time. Bitches gotta drive 2 hours for you, pay him. 2 hours for you, pay him, give him a blowjob. Give a blowjob. Wait, what? Bitches gotta drive 2 hours for you. Oh, okay, I got it. Just mocking. Start up a snowball. Some meth, maybe. It's meth or cocaine. I really don't know the difference, guys. I'm not really that entertained with drugs. Because my last record deal was 400 M's. These days, that's a low ball. 400 million. How much you made on his last album. Or last deal, I mean. Guns. Always knew I had to smoke y'all niggas. Good kid, man, city van, real pop the legend, make the door slide. Tears running down my cheek, laughing at you pussy dying. It's a war cry, cheeks laughing, tears running down my cheeks, laughing at you pussies dying. It's a war cry, that's a nice metaphor. Weekend music getting played in all the spots where boys got a little more pride. Weekend music, now existing weekend. That's why all your friends dipping to Atlanta paying just to find a tour guy. Able run your fucking bread, need to buy some more chains for some more guys. Let me find another street nigga I can take to the game court side. Let me get a useful ride for a rapper, take a nigga on a horse ride. Anything to take a spotlight off the fat boss is a drug download. Poor sissy for the nuts. Wait. Horse ride. Wait. Able run your fucking bread, need to buy some more chains for some more guys. So basically what he's saying is that you need more money from Abel, but I'm not sure who Abel is, but Abel is the one that runs all the money between you and everybody else, so therefore you need more chains and you need more money to fuck with me. Let me find another street I can take to the game courtside, like balling, but also balling as in balling, but also balling like money to the game courtside. Let me get a used Ferrari for a rapper. Take him on a horse ride. Ferrari, because Ferrari, if you look at the logo, it's a horse. It's a double on a rapper, but also like a horse ride. Because when you drive in a Ferrari, you're driving a car, but the logo is a horse. So therefore, you know, yeah. Let me get a used Ferrari for a rapper. Take the nigga on a horse ride. Anything to take the spotlight off the fact that the boss is a drugged out little punk sissy from the north side. I don't know who he's referencing. Like, I don't know who the boss is. Then they take a spotlight off the fat boss is a drug down low. Punk sissy from the north side. Rock him talking shit again. Gas cause you hit my beer first, nigga. Do the math who I was hitting in. I ain't even know you rest there, cause they only talk about your fit again. Probably gotta Okay, making fun of how Kendrick only posts like photos when he dresses on Instagram, but also because he never drops anything usually. Because I know like Kendrick doesn't really drop a lot of songs or a lot of albums, right? Probably gotta have a kid again before you think of dropping any shit again. So basically, just saying you gotta do something with your life, Kendrick, before you actually try to think about me, brother. Have a kid again before you think of dropping any shit again. Even when you do drop, they gonna say you should have modeled because of mid again. Okay. So basically, making fun of his last few albums. I'm not too sure because I don't really listen to Kendrick, guys. But I'm assuming that Kendrick doesn't drop a lot of music and he drops a few years. So therefore, he's saying that. But you think of dropping any shit again. Even when you do drop, they gonna say you should have modeled because it's mid. Modeled because it's mid again, because your music's mid, but also at the same time, you should model as in like. If you just model yourself as in on Instagram, like a model. drop, they're gonna say you should have modeled because it's mid game. What? Ask Fring if this is a good, if this a good, good the idea. Next time you cuddled in the bed again. Shit, leave and tell your leader boy alone before you get your head split again. Pluto shit made me sick to my stomach. We ain't never really been through it. Lil Wayne, you're fucking lame, so I know he had to be an influence. Lil Wayne, why is he dissing Lil Wayne? These niggas had a plan and they finally found a way to work it into it. Two separate albums dissing, I just did a kim to it. Niggas skimmed through it. Me and Savage had a hose dripping wet. Me and Savage, 21 Savage. Had the hose dripping wet at shows, almost had to swim to it. He's basically talking about how good he is compared to Kendrick. That's his reference to Baby King being on the track called Thai Brothers, I'm assuming, with Kendrick. Ross calling me the white boy and the shit kind of got a ring to it. Yeah, that's true. If you listen to the Ross, like the Rick Ross song, it's just so corny in the way that he says white boy, but also at the same time, he's saying like it's a ring to it, as in like a ring on the phone, but also like, you guys get what I mean. Waving a white flag because the battle is over. Murder scene on your man tonight. Murder scene on your man tonight. Then come to vision with a candlelight. Body at the fucking body, and you know Rick reading my Miranda rights. Sort of reminds me of something like praying, like a seance for someone's death during a funeral. Maybe I'm wrong, because that's sort of what I see. Going on vacation, I hope next time y'all plan it right, because you gotta pay for saying my name. Guess now niggas understand the price. Okay, you understand the price because you got to pay for my name, for saying my name, because I'm worth that much because I'm a hit maker based on his last diss track, but also understand the price because now you understand the price of what it costs you in terms of rap battles, but also what it actually costs you in terms of money, like monetary money. What? Where's this? Somewhere in Toronto, I guess. Hey, can you just open his mouth? Someone go hand him a Grammy right now. He's talking about how he's not even a man. Getting an ass whooping, hand him out. That's Adonis, right? Pharrell, wait. Can't listen to lies that come out of your mouth. You got it too by mistake. And they gonna sue me and get that shit down. I'm losing perspective on people. They're basically talking about the West Coast as in Tupac, but also West Coast as in real estate, trying to send something to him like a threat. Boy, what? Boy wanna send beat and I'll kill you for fun. Happy divorce, happy co-parenting? Interesting. But texting your phone like we already won. You tell me what I shouldn't say. But fucking my nigga, it's already done. We already know it's a 20v1. We already know why you want number one. So 20v1, Michael Jackson right here, the reference, but also the kick about co-parenting, about divorcing, about his wife, about Y84 L Ford. What else is there? I don't know what this one is. Reference to something about all the girls he's smashing? Fucking my nigga, it's already done. We already know it's 20v1, another flip to that game. We already know why you want number one. It's clearly because of the boy. The honorable thing is to give me the loot. Give me the loot, reference to Biggie's song, Give Me the Loot, maybe. But also, because it's also Big 3. Okay, I get it. Give Me the Loot, Big 3, Biggie. Okay. But also Big 3 as in the other song that he did. But then it's only Big D as in Big Drake. Also, I got a big, you know, there's video proof. Okay, that's the double on top of the video proof of what happened based on that. Because it's a double, okay, guys? Big D as in, you know, Big Drake, but also Big D as in, you know, guys, what I mean? With that thing that happened with Drake. Right about for the Big 3. It's only Big D and it's video proof. My son should go play in the park. Two light-skinned kids, the shit will be cute. Damn, he's making fun of his kids now. Unless you don't want to be seen with anyone that isn't blacker than you, we get it. We got it. The blacker than berry, the sweeter than okay, reference to Tupac. Now he's dissing him again, but also indirectly dissing Tupac right here. Wait, what? Because like you're drunk. We get that you think you bishop and juice. Bishop and juice. Because bishop is... Was that Tupac and juice? Because I know there's a, like, there's a movie from 1992 or 1995 with Tupac. And he's shooting a gun, right? Maybe I'm wrong. Okay, so basically what he's saying is like, you're digging up shit. Because Kendrick referenced like, I dug up your grave. I dug something about your past, about your family. And like, he's putting a narrative on that. Self-defense, she bigger than you. Your back is up against the curb. You dig it for dirt, she be digging for proof. Why did you move to New York? Is it because you live in that bachelor life? The polls in 2015. But don't want to make her your actual wife. I'm guessing this wedding ain't happening right. Because we know the... Wait, I thought they were married. So they're fiancés? You actually like the darker secrets are coming in light. It's all on your face like what happened to Mike. It's all on your face like Mike because you're going from light to dark like Michael Jackson because Michael Jackson has... The disease called, what is it called? Vertigo? I can't even say the word, guys. But you guys know what I mean, because Michael Jackson had this, like, disease. Skin disease. Wait, whoa, that's a double. Praying for change because he was actually white. Because you go from black to white, but also Prince and Mike because they both looked up to each other to an extent, but they're also big idols to each other, like Prince and Michael. Wait, Top will make you do a feature for change. Get on pop records and rap for whites. Did he actually do that?
Gotta be over by now for anyone out here that's calling it right. Clean up the fact that you beat on your clean, the picture you painted, and all
the same. Get in. I don't know, that was like, it was like a lot of bars in that song. Some bars I didn't really catch, guys. Like, you guys can, you know, correct me if I'm wrong here. I mean, I really don't know. I mean, because some of the lines I didn't really understand, but some of them I did. You're dead? I don't know if he's actually dead, guys. Because we know Kendrick can come back to this. And I know, like, based on what I've seen, that he released more tracks. So let's dive into it and let's see what Kendrick has to say about this. Now, I didn't catch this the first time, but understand the title of this song, Family Matters, is the same thing as this series over here, as you can see. They ended on their fifth season, which is the same thing of how many albums Kendrick Lamar has. So what is Drake saying? Drake is basically saying that Kendrick Lamar's career is about to end with this song.